Okay, so today we're going to do the whole house filtration, right? So let's show everyone here that I've got a big audience. Okay, we've got 2,000 people here. Don't show the rest of the people, just the few people, right? So say hello to Session quickly. Alright, we can't show the other thousands of people, so let's just get into it. So now in your water shop, you've learned all those products already, the simple stuff. Now, this is a very popular unit, right, Manuel?
Yes.
We sell a lot of these. In fact, we sell like maybe a couple thousands every month.
Every installation basically is selling one of those.
So, this is called a three-stage Big Blue. Some people call it whole house system. Now, when a person's doing water filtration and they're just getting into like have something entry level and they don't have enough money to spend, this is the unit. It's a budget unit, right? Now we've got three models, three different kind of models. Now first thing, I'm going to explain everything to you. The pricing we'll discuss after the video, because there's different pricing structures. So this is a three stage. We call it the bracket system, right? So it's basically three big blue housings. We assemble it here locally and we put it we put it on a bracket. And now I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the filters that goes in firstly. Now our standard configuration of this filters is we have two sediment filters, right? So we discussed the microns last week. So normally we put a 5 micron first, then we have a carbon block filter. So we always bring the broken ones first to put on the videos. And then another 1 micron at the end. So Manuel, you had one the other day, if you can run quickly and
what
find
is
it.
There?
The dirty one.
Yes.
So it's 5 carbon and 1.
Yes. So 5 micron, carbon block, and 1 micron. Now, where this gets interesting is, I want to show you this now, right? Before we move further. Now, on tap water, your tap water looks clear. You cannot see any dirt. It's clear, you can see through it. But if you run it through this filter for a few months, and it ends up like this color, where's the particles come from? It's in your water and wasn't visible to your naked eye. So this is what the filter would look like. Now, depending how dirty your water is, which city you're in, that will make all the difference to your system. Right? So this is what it looks like. Now, this system has its advantages and disadvantages. The disadvantage of this system is when this filter is blocked, you cannot take it out and wash it and use it again. It's blocked. You have to take it out and throw it away. Now it becomes expensive when you have to get someone to get a technician out, unless you guys are doing it, or the homeowner is a handyman, then it's cheap. It's just a matter of like opening a bottle, taking it out, throwing it away, and putting a new one in. But so this is just to show you. So normally what happens is the 5 micron will catch the bigger particles. Then you've got the carbon block, which is taste and odor and chemicals that it absorbs. And the last stage is the 1 micron. So I think every house should have this at the entry level. So entry going into the house should have a three stage like this. And then for your drinking water, you should have a reverse osmosis system, because this one has no wastewater. It's just one inlet, one outlet. Your reverse osmosis has got wastewater.
So from there to the
RO. From there, it can feed into the whole house. And then at your point where you're going to, in your kitchen, you can have the RO system in there. So that's why this is the most popular system that you would find. Now, there's three different models.
Where do you install it?
You would put it at the entrance to the house. Yeah, on your entrance coming, at your pipeline entrance, I mean.
Yeah.
not at the entrance of the door.
Okay,
I have to answer. Actually, we had customers, right? It might sound funny to you. I had some customers, they put the filter like this, put the plastic. They run it for 1 year, then they come, the thing is still brand new after 1 year. We had plenty of customers. So that's why I'm saying at the entrance of the door, don't put it in your doorway. Make sure, I mean the pipe walk, after your meter, your pipe's running into the house. So normally you'll have your inlet coming in, and we normally put three ball valves, so when you, if anything had to go wrong with the filter system, you'll close the two ball valves and you have a bypass around it, and you'll open that. So I'll give you a diagram to follow. But the first ones we'll install. So okay, so you can see there's three types here, right? Now we've got different types of housings that we're using, different prices. Like we import from China, we import from Vietnam, and we import from Taiwan. So the China price is the cheapest one. Taiwan and Vietnam is a little bit more expensive. But we don't bring housings from the filter cartridges we bring from Vietnam. But the filter housings, the best quality comes from Taiwan, but the price is a lot more. So we've also got, we didn't have it on display now, we've also got the Taiwan models that have a pressure gauge here. Because what will happen is, when your water is coming in, and these filters get blocked up, then your pressure will, you know, there's resistance in the line. So then you'll have a pressure gauge here that will see, and it will block up your... do we have one in there? Yeah, let's bring it in and put it on the video. That's fine with one housing. Everything is missing one part here on the display. So, alright. Yeah. So normally this, if you look at it, okay, this is at the outlet. So what would happen is, the pressure will build up, and then you'll see your pressure is rising. Then you know your cart filter. That's how you know your filter cartridges are blocked, by watching the gauge. Because when it's blocked, it will restrict the flow. You won't have enough pressure in your showers and things like that, right? So for this video, we're only talking about a three stage. We also have a two stage, right? So let's just move that one to this side. Now, the differences on all of these are the prices. So the two stage, we're talking about these three models now. See, this one has just got a bracket, so there's less material used. Compared to this one, both of them can, if they're using the same housings, they both will do exactly the same function, but this one's got an extra piece of the stand to it. So the price might be a little bit more than that one. So that's the only difference here. We got different quality of housings, but what we're trying to do is we sell a Taiwan model and we sell a Chinese model. Chinese model is obviously cheaper, and the Taiwanese generally try to use the most best raw materials. Like we were talking about carbon, for example. Most of the suppliers in Taiwan would use coconut carbon with a high iodine value, but in China they would use, you know, the cheaper carbon. So the same filter, you can buy two of the same filters, but one of them, the price will be double compared to, you know, like the Chinese one might be, let's say, 150 rand, and the Taiwan will be 300 rand because of the carbon used in it. But the appearance looks exactly the same. You won't even know that. All right, so now you know three stage. So this here, this is just, this is what we call a UV light, right? Now, a UV light is basically a piece of pipe. This is a stainless steel pipe, and it's got a light inside it. Okay, we won't do that one right now, but it's got a light inside, and that light gives off radiation. It gives off a ray that kills bacteria on the line. So as the water flows through here, after it flows through the machine, it goes through the UV light and it kills bacteria while it's, so your water in your house is essentially free from bacteria. But this only works for municipal systems. If there's heavy amounts of bacteria, then you need to use other methods like putting chlorine or ultrafiltration. So here you have pre-stage plus UV. Now, like I said, we have different, we might have, customer might choose a Taiwan system for the UV light, or they might choose a Chinese system with the UV light. It will have different pricing. Mm-hmm. But it all works the same functionality, just that the Taiwan has got better quality housings. It takes a lot more to burst that housing. Also, the cheaper housings, they may use recycled material, whereas the more expensive ones use virgin material. So it hasn't, it's very strong, much more stronger. Even sometimes, we don't recommend that you put this in the sun. Some people put them in the sun. The Chinese ones a few years ago, because of sunlight, were changing the color, because anything you leave in the sun, it fades.
Yeah.
So we always recommend that this needs to be installed under cover, just not in the sunlight. You can install it outside, but not in the sunlight. And then when it comes to the UV part, you need to have a power box that's waterproof, so that with electricity, you don't want water to go in there and have a short circuit. So now's the time for questions.
I was going to ask about the insulation and the place for it. So generally, people that live in apartments might be a bit difficult with these sort of
units. We haven't installed much in apartments. More standalone houses.
Yeah.
Because after your mains coming into the house, you have your meter, and then after your meter, because this has to be installed after your meter. So.
And the meter is normally on the border of the property.
It doesn't have to be at the border, because from your meter you have a pipe running into your house.
Yeah.
And then as it comes into your house, not the entrance, the pipe that's entering, the pipe were coming into the house. Yeah. At that point you mount it on the wall, preferably not facing the sun.
Mm. And that you need a plumber to do that kind of work.
You need a plumber.
Yeah.
Ordinary plumber can do this one. It's very straightforward in and out.
So the actual piping fittings, you supply the entire unit?
We supply the whole unit, but it's got 1-inch inlet and outlet.
Right.
90% of them have 1-inch. Some people ask for 1.5-inch.
Yeah.
So it's a standard size. It's all, there's no special fittings that you need, all standard fittings.
Yeah.
And how often do you change the filters?
Now the filters, depending on area to area, there's some places that you might need to change the filters every 2 weeks. But for general use, we recommend once a year. For Johannesburg, we recommend once a year. If you have to go live in, let's say, Bella Bella or Richards Bay, the water is very bad. It'll turn like this in a month. Then you need to change it more frequently.
So without the pressure gauge, how would you know that
you feel the flow
of the water?
You have to manually open it. So every unit comes with a wrench or spanner, whatever you want to call it. You take it and you... Remember I told you need to put ball valves before or after. So you'll close the ball valves. There's a button here to release the pressure. And then you'll open the first filter. Normally you open the first filter and you can see. So even if you want, even some people do this, you don't have to change all the filters frequently. You can just change the first one, because remember the first one is doing
catching
the most dirt. So you can change the first one. So if you want to change this once a year, maybe every 6 months, change the first one. Right now, the prices of a filter like this is about maybe 100 to 150, depending.
Are you going to delete that from the video?
No, but nobody's going to see. This is a special video only for
okay, just another question. If obviously this works on houses,
yes.
Standalone houses, and if a house has a pool, for example,
yes.
And if you emptying your pool or refilling your pool and stuff, do
bypass.
You... You have to bypass it, or
you can bypass it, but this is where now these filters are once off use, right? Now we're moving on to the next level after this.
Okay.
You can just show those vessels there. So we're gonna go back to that one next. So
when you said once off use, meaning
After you use the filter,
all of the filter itself you chuck it away.
That's okay, the filter, so it's conscious. So there's no there's no use for it afterwards.
So with the, you know, sometimes we think we're only going to drink our water by to have units installed.
Remember also when you use this in your house, right? Let's say you put it at the mains in your house, and then you have an RO system afterwards.
Yeah.
Then it means your RO systems, your RO system will need less filter changes, because this one is catching, the first one is catching most of the dirt. Okay, you're asking?
No, you know, you read articles all the time.
Yeah.
People's shower heads get clogged and damaged, washing machines pack up because of...
This won't help with that. This won't help with that.
Okay.
This is purely for sediment removal. It can only remove sediment.
Yeah, but even with the, that will help, because I mean, the
it will help a little bit.
The washing machine.
It will help a little bit, right? But generally, when it comes to washing machine, and okay, not too much washing machine, your heating appliances, you'll get scale buildup. A scale is a calcium magnesium buildup that that's hardness in the water.
Yeah,
that will not be removed by this.
Okay.
This is purely
sediment
removal, and little bit of chlorine and little bit of taste and odor, depending on the quality of the carbon.
Okay.
So when you're buying, you tell me you want a cheaper one or you want, we sell both.
Okay.
So your decision which one you like. So next question, Manuel asked some questions.
Now, that system is just purely a filtration system. It doesn't remove heavy metals and chemicals.
It doesn't remove anything dissolved.
Osmosis does that.
Okay.
Anything dissolved in the water.
Yeah.
If you test the water before and you test the water after, your chemical composition is the same.
Yeah.
It will mainly, this is just tiny particles. So things like your turbidity would be reduced. You know, tiny particles. Or, Sushin, you got a question? You were studying this one?
Yeah, no, I was just studying it. I wasn't studying it that deep.
Okay.
Yes, man.
Cameraman?
I'm good.
No questions. Okay. So that sums it up for this one then. So we got, let's call it whole house systems.
Okay.
Or we have a two stage and a three stage big glue. That's what it's called, right? Okay, so that's it for this
The pressure gauge, just a bit on the pressure gauge as well.
The pressure gauge, yeah?
Yeah, you said when the filters are getting clogged, you'll get less pressure.
Yes, the, no.
You find it going up?
It will go up,
more.
Because now you're, it's struggling to get through.
Yeah.
The pressure goes up.
Okay.
While it's running. So, no more questions?
No
more.
Okay, if you think of something, let me know, because we're going to share this video with all our staff.
Okay.
And it'll save me from sounding like a broken record. I think